Good morning, student. Today I am here to discuss a very important law of physics known as Ohm's law, student. But students, simply merely discussing Ohm's law and its statement will not make our purpose solve. We have to understand the basic concept behind it. Then only we should start in the name of a law. This law, many of you must have studied also. Though it looks very simple, it is written like this, okay? That when a constant current is passed through a conductor, it is proportional to potential difference. But the condition is, physical condition must remain same. Physical condition should remain same. This proportionality sign is there. Say there is a conductor. Conductor symbol is this instrument. Because every substance opposes the current. Though conductor it opposes less, insulator it opposes high. But when current is passed, some opposition is there. It will oppose. So that is shown by this symbol. Written as R. Here I have connected a battery. This is the direction of current, student. Okay. So what Ohm's law says is, suppose I change this voltage, current will also change. Current will change means, suppose, student, now I have applied 0.5 volt and say the current is 1 milliampere. 1 milliampere means, student, 1 into 10 raised to minus 3 ampere. Okay, it is a smaller unit because 1 ampere current is very high. Previously we have defined how much is 1 ampere current. 1 ampere current is 1 coulomb of charge passes 1 second. And this 1 coulomb is a very higher number of charges. Okay, student. Suppose this much is the voltage. This is the current. Now I increase it. Okay, student. So when I am increasing this, first you find out this ratio. V upon I. How much it is coming, student? Say, student, to make it more simpler, let me not take it 5.5, let me take it 5, student. I am taking 5. First, 5 volt. So, how much is V upon I, student? Here I am writing, V upon I is how much? 5. Now suppose, student, I increase this voltage 10 volt. So the current, say it is becoming 2 mA. Again you see V upon I, 10 by 2, again it is coming 5. Now I am increasing to 15 voltage, it is becoming 3. Again you see V upon I is coming out to be 5. So have you noted, see, student, what is happening in this case? That in this case what is happening is V upon I is constant. This is in mathematics we write like this. This is what is Ohm's law is. But remember, Ohm's law is applicable under certain conditions. It is not applicable for every device, every substance. Mostly it is applicable for metals, and that too at some lower temperature. At very high temperature, this relation does not valid. Because with increase in temperature, the value of this R changes. We will do it in detail. See, student, Ohm's law simply says this much. That potential difference across any point of the conductor is proportional to current. Which means V upon I is a constant. Now, student, this constant name is R, known as resistance. and its unit is ohm. This is basically what the Ohm's law is about, student. Now I will come into the detailed picture of it. This is simply what I've said is in the theory which is there in the 10th class, okay? But as I said, by merely studying it will not solve our purpose. Now I'm coming to the basic theory of it, and that is circuit theory. Come to this figure, student. This is a resistor. See, can you see a hill-like thing? Hill-like thing means any substance. When current is passed, it will oppose. It will try to oppose. That opposition is shown in the form of R. This is very high in case of insulators and less in case of conductors. But every substance has some opposition. It will try to oppose the flow of current. So that is known as, that is the device known as resistor. Means everything is a resistor. And the property is known as resistance. So student, remember, current is flowing in this direction. And current flows only when there is a potential difference. Current flows only when there is a potential difference. As in case of water. Water flows only when there is a difference in level. Higher level to lower level. Temperature flows when there is a difference. Sorry, heat flows when there is a difference in temperature. Higher temperature to low temperature. Okay. Similarly, current flows when there is a difference of potential. So what you have to remember, student, in case of resistor, this is at high potential. This is at low. I have written H and L. So in case of resistor, current will always flow from high potential to low potential. Current, I should write always. Current will always, means if the current is flowing in this side, this means this is at higher potential, this is at lower potential. This is always a student. Now let's come into the battery, the cell part of it. As I said, cell or battery. Cell is a, battery is a combination of cell. But in case of battery, student, see here current is flowing in this side. But here current is in opposite direction. Though always this positive, this is always at higher potential. This is at higher one. But in battery, both the cases are possible. This is possible when you connect here a higher voltage than this. Means charging a battery. And this is general case, what we are studying. So in case of battery, current is possible in both the directions. That you have to remember. In case of battery, I can flow in both the directions. Okay, student, first basic, second basic. Now, third basic. How the current flows? How current flows? What is the condition? This you have to understand, student. What is the condition? First condition. There should be a continuous path. Continuous path means, student, I am drawing it here. So this is a conductor. This is the path. See, it is continuous. or there is one more word, closed. So for current to flow, there must be a closed loop, student. Suppose I break it from here. Now current cannot flow. First condition. Second, what is flowing? Charge. Presence of charge. There should be a continuous presence of charge everywhere, student. This is the second condition. Now I am completing it. There should be a continuous presence of charge throughout. Second condition for the current to flow. Now third thing, student, already we know it. Anything cannot move on its own. You have to apply some force. So here some energy is required to make the charge flow in a particular direction. And that source of energy is connected here, student. Here the source is there. And this source, the name is EMF device. Means as there must be something which supplies energy. Say when you are riding the cycle, you are using your muscular energy on the pedal. That pedal is applying force on the chain of your cycle. And that chain is making the wheels of the cycle to move. So ultimately it is your muscular energy which is converted into the mechanical energy of the cycle, kinetic energy of the cycle. So your muscular energy is used up. You are supplying it. Similarly, we have a source which will supply energy to these charges. And the name of that source is EMF device. This EMF device, the full form already I told you before, student. It is electromotive force. So before, see, condition first, second, third condition is there must be an EMF device. So have you understood the meaning of EMF device? It is the source which will supply energy to the charged particle to move. These are the three conditions, student, where the current can flow. Now I am talking about EMF in detail. One EMF device which you generally use is cell. What cell does is, it converts chemical energy into electrical. We have another EMF device known as generator. It converts mechanical energy into electrical. Everywhere energy conversion is there, as I told you in case of cycles. In case of car also, student, there is a generator, dynamo connected inside. So that dynamo is first given mechanical energy. And then it sparks and it gives energy to the car. Today I will talk about this cell. This is actually, we will discuss it in later on. This cell, student. I am drawing this figure again here. Here I have connected the EMF device. Say it is a cell. Say this is positive, this is negative. So this cell is pushing the electrons or charged particle, okay, along this side. It is pushing it. how it will push the student. Again the basic, see here. In the first day I told you, there is a property called mass. It attracts other particle. How it attracts? It creates a field known as gravitational field. Similarly, there is a property of a substance known as charge. This charge attracts or repels other charges. It creates a field known as electrical field. Suppose there is a positive charge. Positive charge means it is having lack of electrons to make it zero. Suppose I bring another charge here. Anyway, this charge repels along this side. So this line is the electric field, student. This is the direction of electric field. Means the direction of force on a positive charge. Suppose I bring negative charge here. This will attract. This means the negative charge will move opposite to the electric field. This is by convention taken as direction of electric field. Getting what I am saying? Direction of electric field is that direction along which the force on positive charge acts. And it comes out from the positive charge. So suppose I have drawn a line like this. Now understand the basic. I am simply drawing a line. I am writing E. Okay. What you understood is, if I bring a positive charge here, this field will apply force on this along this side. If I bring negative charge here, this will apply force on this side. Understood, student? So it is this field which applies force on the charged particle. And who is creating this field? This cell. Okay. Now see, student. The cell pushes the, say, electron in this side. If electron is coming in this side, and here say I have connected a bulb. Here I have connected a fan. Here I have connected a heater. So this energy which is given by the cell, kinetic energy, that energy manifests itself in the light here, in the fan it is mechanical energy, means that energy is used up. As I am saying, you are pedaling a cycle, so you are getting tired, your energy is used up and cycle is moving. So this energy of electron is used up, see, bulb, fan, heater. The energy received, it is using it. Now when it reaches here, the energy has been utilized. Again the cell supplies the energy to it while traveling from here to here. This cell gives energy to that electron. And again that electron comes out. I am saying one electron, but there are many electrons which comes out. Now student, try to understand the meaning of EMF. Remember, it is connected with the device. Cell. What is the meaning of EMF? EMF means energy supplied to 1 coulomb charge. Energy supplied to 1 coulomb charge by the source. Source in this case is cell. This energy supplied is known as EMF. And its unit is measured in volts. A cell has this much EMF. What is the meaning of this? That the cell will supply this much energy to 1 coulomb charge. And that energy we are using it. So this is the meaning of EMF. Say it is written in volt. Okay, student. So this is one basic concept which I make you understand. Now next thing, friend. We have different electrical devices, but we cannot draw the devices in the notebook or in the copy. So what has been done is we have made a symbol. That symbol will represent that devices. And when these devices are connected, drawn by the help of symbol and connected, it becomes an electrical circuit. Now for cell, this is the symbol. This is positive, this is negative. Generally what will happen, the current will come out from this and it will enter this. But remember, student, current will never end at certain point. It will continue. Remember this word. It appears that current is starting from here, ending at there. No. There is a continuous. Here I am connecting a circuit. This is resistance R. This is an arrangement known as rheostat. If you change this slider, the resistance will change, the current can be changed. Now, how to make the circuit on and off? We have a key, student. I am connecting it here. This is known as plug key. Okay, student, this is electrical circuit. You can connect ammeter here. You can connect a voltmeter here. Negative, negative, plus. And then you can use this circuit for studying Ohm's law, which I have explained to you. Now, one more very important basic, student. Suppose this is the cell. Say it is 1.5 volt. Just now I told you it is the EMF. We have, student, also defined one term, potential difference. And what is the definition of potential difference? Work done to move 1 coulomb charge from one point to other. Okay? So here what happened, now this cell is not supplying any current. EMF is this much. Now if I measure potential difference, it will come out to be 1.5. So now come see, these two values are coming same. But remember, student, these two are totally different quantities. This is connected with the device, that cell. How much energy that cell will supply for 1 coulomb charge? And this is connected with the two points in the circuit. How much is the work required or work done in moving 1 coulomb charge from one point to the another? So their values are coming out to be same in this case, okay? But these two are totally, they are different terms that you have to understand. One is connected with device, one is connected with potential difference. As soon as this circuit is made on, student, on means, say we are supplying through resistor. Say current I is flowing. So between these two points, I will write potential difference as I into R. V is 1.5 volt. This you have to write. So these are the certain basic strength of the circuit theory. We'll come into it again and again. Now let's talk about, student, about this term, this resistor, resistance. Suppose I take a wire of particular length L and I connected a battery through it and I measured the current I. Current I is given by V upon R. Now I make the length double. So it is observed that current is becoming half. How current will become half? This means the resistance has increased. So this is one factor on which resistance depends, directly proportional to length. Second factor, student. Suppose I take the wire of different cross section. This is cross section is less, this is higher. If you compare these two, from here current can flow easily as compared to here. This means when I say current can flow easily means higher current can flow here. And higher current means less resistance. So by increasing this area, we are decreasing the resistance is decreased. Second factor. This is known as area of cross section. When I equate, there is a constant comes, student. This constant is known as resistivity. It depends on the nature of the substance and temperature. So generally we are doing the experiment as a constant temperature, so it is depending only on the nature in that case. Now what is the meaning of this nature, students? See. I am writing the formula once again. Okay, student. This has a unit ohm. This has a unit ohm meter. Now, student, see about this substance. Suppose I take copper wire, different length. This is also copper. This is also copper. What is the similarity in all the three? They are made of copper, but they are different length, different area. But to remember, student, in all the three cases, this will be same. This is the meaning of nature. Nature is copper only, so rho is same in all the cases. But R will differ. Why R will differ? Because they have different length, different area of cross section. Now, student, will define this rho. How see? This R you take 1 ohm, L you take 1 meter. Area will take 1 square meter. Sorry, student. Here I should write R. If I take L1 and A1, then rho is becoming equal to R. From here I can define what is resistivity. Resistivity is equal to the resistance of that substance having length 1 meter with area of cross section 1 square meter. Very easy definition of resistivity. What is resistivity? It is equivalent to the resistance of the substance of unit length and unit area of cross section. And what is resistance? Already we know V upon I. V is volt. I is ampere. 1 volt potential difference and 1 ampere current is flowing, then the resistance is said to be 1 ohm. if by the help of 1 volt difference 1 ampere current is sent. So that substance that will set to have a 1 ohm resistance. This is the point. So today, student, we have discussed the Ohm's law, we have discussed the basic of circuit theory. So today your homework will be to write down this what has been taught in your own words and some extra terms from the book. This will be your homework, student. We will continue in the next class. Thank you, student.